Isn't it great to know that we serve a faithful God? Isn't it great to know that He is so faithful that even when we are faithless, He remains faithful because He cannot deny Himself? Yep, that's our passage, 2 Timothy 2:13. And I know, I'm taking away one of your favorite passages, but just hear me out. It doesn't mean what you think it means in one way, but in another way, it does mean what you think it means. Okay, let me explain. This passage comes in 2 Timothy 2:13. And if you look in your Bible, you'll see that this little section is set apart, probably indented in your Bible. And it has these four lines that are indented. Now that is alerting us that normally this is some type of song or some type of poem. It's set in meter or in rhythm. And the entire section must be taken together. And here's how the verse goes. If we die with Him, we will also live with Him. If we endure, we will also reign. If we deny Him, He will deny us. If we are faithless, He remains faithful. And then another little section says, for He cannot deny Himself. Now, you'll notice these are basically four statements that are set in an if-then scenario. So you got if and then. It's called the protasis and the apodosis. The protasis tells us the condition. If we die with Him, then we will live with Him. If we endure with Him, we will reign. Those are the first two. Now, notice in these first two, that's good news. If we die, we will live. If we endure, we will reign. Good news. If we do these things, good news is coming. But the second set, the next two, are not quite so good in their news. In one way, they are. But in some ways, they're not, because it is just the opposite of the first two. It's kind of like saying, okay, if we do those first two, great news. However, first one, if we deny Him, He will deny us. That's not good, okay? In some sense, yes, it is good, because as we'll see, He can't deny Himself, but it's not good in the sense of denying Him, because it has bad results. If we deny Jesus, if we do not believe in Him, if we do not trust Him, then He will deny us. We will not have a part in the kingdom of heaven. He will not confess us before the Father. Okay, that's the first part of the bad news. But see, you got to understand, this next part is the beloved part of the verse that we love so much. And it says, if we are faithless, He remains faithful. That parallels the denying part. If we deny Him, if we are faithless, those two are paralleling. So it's the same scenario. It's the same thing happening with a way of saying the result in different ways. So just as whenever we are faithless, or just whenever we deny Him, He denies us. Now, whenever we are faithless, He is faithful. But what does it mean He is faithful? How does that parallel Him denying us? Well, it parallels it in the sense that He's faithful to His character. If we deny Him, He is faithful to His character, and He will also deny us. That's what it's talking about. And that's why right afterwards, it says, no longer in the song or in the poem, it says, for He cannot deny Himself. And the idea here is that He has to remain faithful to who He is. He will always be who He is. Therefore, if we deny Him, He has to remain faithful to Himself, to His character, to His righteousness, and deny us. So that's the parallel here. Now, of course, it turns the good news of that verse into not so good news. But it's not bad news for us. It's just bad news for those who do not trust in Christ. It's not bad news for us, because we've already got the guarantees that when we die with Him, we will live with Him, that when we endure with Him, we will reign with Him. That good news is already set aside, and He will not deny that. He will not deny himself of allowing us to reign with him and live with him, because he can't deny his character. He has died for us. He has paid that price. And therefore, whenever we trust in him, it is within his character. It is stable within his character that he will let us reign with him, that we will live with him. But just the same, denying him, being faithless, causes him to be faithful to his character and his righteousness, and denying us. So that's how this verse goes. That's what this verse means. If we are faithless, he remains faithful. Now, I believe that that is true whenever we have times of faithlessness, because we all do. So please don't think I'm jumping all over the concept. The concept is true, that he is gracious to us, that we don't have to be perfect, that we can have problems in our faith and difficulties, and I believe, Lord, help my unbelief. But that's not what this particular verse is talking about. This verse talks about the stability of his character to bring about both our redemption and our judgment if we deny him.